Welcome back to Proactive, and I'm joined now by Rob Clements, who is the Chief Commercial Officer at MGC Pharmaceuticals. So, Rob, it's been a little while since we last spoke. How have you been keeping?
Yes, great. Thank you. Life is good, and it's good to see you again. It's been a while.
Certainly has, and it looks like the company's been very busy. We've got plenty of news out from you in the last couple of weeks. Perhaps we could start with the changes at the board level.
Yes, there's been some recent announcements about some boardroom changes. Quite exciting, as the announcement said, that we've been on a long journey from medicinal cannabis towards pharma. And there's been a lot of work and a lot of contribution by the previous board. And all that's really happened is that there have been some boardroom changes to reflect that direction of travel. Some of the people that have come in, like the interim non-executive chair, are very much pharma people. And as our focus, as I always talk to you about, our focus continues to move towards pharma. We've just put a team in place that will be even more focused on that, making sure that we succeed in trials and deliver on commercial outcomes and things like that.
Thank you, Rob. Now, turning to something that's probably more relevant to your day-to-day work, you've managed to deliver the first dose of CannEpil here in the UK. So what does this mean for the business?
Well, yes, we've been working hard and long with various routes of bringing CannEpil to the UK. And in fact, we have just announced that two routes have been fulfilled. Firstly, the named patient request route we have delivered into the UK, which means that for an IMD, that a GMC registered a specialist can prescribe CannEpil and a patient has received it that way, which is important because, as I keep emphasizing, we like to take the steps properly and establish a channel for the long term. And secondly, our first patient has been delivered their stock in the RESCAS study, the refractory epilepsy study, with the help of the Iron Billy Foundation, who are so well known here in the UK and abroad. And that young patient has received their CannEpil, which means that over the next 6 months, that patient will be evaluated to look at the improvement in their symptoms. We've also supplied our app to the physician involved in that so that they can monitor. Obviously, it means we can refine the app as we go. And hopefully at the end of that period of time, the idea with the RESCAS study is patients can then be prescribed on the NHS. One of the constant mantras you'll hear is that of 27,000 patients or whatever, there have only been literally five NHS scripts. Although the funding route exists, it's still very rare. And you have to prove that your product is working. So patients are benefiting. We're making sure we're establishing the right channels, and we're sort of adding to the clinical evidence, the most important thing, on CannEpil, which ultimately leads towards its registration with an MA. So, yeah, we have been busy, and we keep chipping away at the iceberg, and eventually we'll have an established pharmaceutical there.
Lovely stuff. Well, I do just have one final question for you, Rob. You say you're going to be chipping away at this iceberg. Let's continue with the analogy. What fragments of this iceberg can we expect to be seeing chipped off over the next couple of months?
You will see more announcements and more progress. MGC is a plant-inspired medicine company. So whether it be with its cannabinoid-derived products, whether it be with its post-viral treatments like Symetra, or whether it is in other areas such as the development of research capability in psychedelics and stuff, MGC will continue to move forward. And commercially, we are focusing our strategy, as I say, both in the pharma sector and separately in the medicinal sector. So we won't be quiet for long, and we'll keep moving forward. And hopefully you'll see more patients entering the RESCAS study, for example. We aren't just committed to one, we're committed to several. And we'd like to see those patients moving forward and moving towards NHS scripts. For me, the day I come on to you and say that the NHS is prescribing and reimbursing CannEpil will be a high point for me. We're not quite there yet, but we're getting very close, and exciting times.
Have to keep chipping away then, Rob. But until then, hopefully we'll get some more updates from you, and I will leave you to enjoy the weekend. And thanks very much for your time today.
Nice to see you again, and you too. Have a great weekend.